Hello, my name is Riza May Guevara. Your name is Erickson Guevara, correct? Okay, we are going to be taking your vital signs today. I've already washed my hands and made sure all of my equipment is working properly and it's necessary. We're just taking your vital signs just to make sure that your health is in good condition. I'm going to go ahead and provide privacy for you right now just to make you feel comfortable. Okay, and would you like your blood pressure done on your left or right today? Your left? Okay, great. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to take your temperature. So I'm going to go ahead and clean my thermometer. So what I do is I take the thermometer and I clean it with either an antiseptic or a cotton ball. And I'm going to make sure that I'm starting just below the base of the thermometer digital display. And work my way up all the way to the tip, making sure I'm not going back, so that I'm making sure that it's fully clean and ready to be used. Okay, just like that. All right, since you are having your blood pressure taken on your left, we're gonna put the thermometer on your right. So I'm gonna press the button, and I'm gonna place it into the axilla of the arm, and I'm gonna make sure that it's directly touching the skin, and that it's in the center of the axilla, okay? I'm gonna ask for you to keep it there tightly, and we're just gonna be waiting for your temperature to be read on the thermometer. While it is reading, I'm going to take the opposite forearm and cross it against your chest or abdomen, and put my index finger and middle finger on top of your radial artery, and I'm going to palpate, and I'm gonna apply light but firm pressure until the pulse is palpated. Okay, now I'm gonna go ahead and count the number of beats for 1 minute, and I'm also gonna take note of the strength and rhythm of your pulse rate, and I'm also gonna take note of the irregular beats if it's an irregular pulse, okay? Okay, now I'm going to do the respiration, and for the respiration, I am not informing the client because it's going to make them conscious of their breathing. So I want to make sure I'm getting an accurate amount of respiration by still keeping this here and making them think I'm still taking their pulse rate. So what I'm doing is I'm counting the number of respiration by observing or feeling the abdomen or chest, and I am taking note of the depth and rhythm of the respiration. I am counting it for 1 minute. Now I'm gonna go ahead and take their blood pressure. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take that same arm, making sure that it's at the level of the heart with their elbow extended and their palm facing upward. So I'm gonna go take the sphygmomanometer and I'm gonna put it into their upper arm. To the left arm, like you said, and we're gonna keep it on the upper arm, just above, like approximately 1 inch above the antecubital space, with the cuff in the center of the brachial artery, on top, above the brachial artery. Center of the cuff is above the brachial artery. Very snug, okay. I'm also gonna put this on top. Okay. So now I'm gonna perform preliminary palpatory determination of systolic pressure. So what I'm going to do first is I am going to palpate the brachial artery with my fingertips. Okay, now that it's palpated, I am going to inflate the cuff. I'm going to note when the pulse is no longer felt. Okay, now I'm gonna deflate the cuff and I'm going to remove the cuff completely. Okay, and now I'm first going to clean my stethoscope before putting them in my ears. I'm gonna clean the diaphragm and the earpieces of my stethoscope, each with an individual pad to make sure that they're fully clean. Okay. After doing so, I'm going to auscultate the client's blood pressure by placing the earpieces into my ears of the stethoscope and then I'm going to place the diaphragm on top of the skin of the brachial artery. Again, I'm placing these earpieces into my ears of the stethoscope and placing the diaphragm on top of the brachial artery. Okay, now I'm going to put back on the cuff onto the upper arm. That it's snug onto my client. Okay, now with my dominant hand, I am going to inflate the cuff until the sphygmomanometer reads 30 millimeters mercury above the point of the brachial pulse. When the brachial pulse disappeared. I am also gonna close my valve first. Okay, now I'm gonna slowly open the valve and making sure that the pressure is falling at a speed of 2 to 3 millimeters mercury per second. And I'm gonna listen for the Korotkov sounds. While looking at the manometer reading. Okay, once the last sound of the Korotkov sounds is heard, I'm going to deflate the puff rapidly and completely. And then I'm going to clean my diaphragm and earpieces of my stethoscope. Again, I'm cleaning it with each of their individual alcohol prep pad. And now I'm going to take the thermometer and I'm going to read the measurement of the display. Okay. And I'm going to clean it as well, starting again from the bottom of the display all the way to the tip of the thermometer to make sure it is clean, not going back. Okay, now I am going to inform you of all your vital signs and I'm going to document them properly and I'm going to now wash my hands. Thank you so much. Hello, so this is the stethoscope. These are the ear tips. This is the biannual. This is the biannual spring. This is the diaphragm. This is the bell. This is the drum. This is the chest piece, basically. And then this part is the latex-free PVC tubing. And this is the non-chill ring right here. And now I'm going to talk about this big manometer. So this is the inflation bulb. This is the end valve. This is the air release valve. This is the bladder hose or tube. This is the aneroid manometer gauge. This is the index marking. This is the Velcro for the cuff. This is the cuff. This is the artery marking. And this is to help adjust for the sphygma manometer. And that is it. Thank you.